"He certainly seems to be very much in love with her," Miss Sally told Joyce one evening when she returned from Eden. "I would believe in him if it were possible for me to believe in a man. Anyway, she will have a dear little home. I've almost come to love that Eden house. Why don't you come down and see it, Joyce?"
"Oh, I'll come some day, I hope," said Joyce lightly. "I think I'd rather not see it until it is finished."
"Willard is a nice boy," said Miss Sally suddenly. "I don't think I ever did him justice before. The finer qualities of his character come out in these simple, homely little doings and tasks. He is certainly very thoughtful and kind."
"Oh, I suppose he'll make a good husband, as husbands go. But he doesn't know the first thing about managing. If his wife isn't a good manager, I don't know what they'll do. And perhaps she won't like the way we've done up Eden. Willard says she will, of course, because he thinks her perfection. But she may have dreadful taste and want the lace curtains and that nightmare of a pink rug Willard admired. And I dare say she'd rather have a new flaunting set of china with rosebuds on it than that dear old bull blue I picked up for a mere song down at Aldenbury auction. I stood in the rain for 2 mortal hours to make sure of it, and it was really worth all that Willard had spent on the dining room put together. It will break my heart if she set to work altering Eden. It's simply perfect as it is, though I suppose I shouldn't say it." In another week, Eden was finished. Miss Sally stood in the tiny hall and looked about her. "Well, it is done," she said with a sigh. "I'm sorry. I have enjoyed fixing it up tremendously, and now I feel that my occupation is gone. I hope you are satisfied, Willard."
"Satisfied is too mild a word, Miss Sally. I am delighted. I knew you could accomplish wonders, but I never hoped for this. Eden is a dream, the dearest, quaintest, sweetest little home that ever waited for a bride. When I bring her here, oh, Miss Sally, do you know what that thought means to me?